We're gonna answer all your questions you have after watching Kate, so if you haven't seen it, stop watching and come back when you've seen it.
This is spoiler alert.
Hey, I'm Mary Elizabeth Winstead, and I play Kate.
I'm Miku Martineau, and I play Ani.
I guess the biggest spoiler, it's so weird to talk about spoilers. It's so conditioned not to do it that I'm really fighting. So Kate, she does die. I think in a movie like this, you might expect maybe they're gonna find a cure. There's gonna be a twist and she's gonna get saved. Big spoiler is that we, you know, stuck with the brave ending.
Another big spoiler is that Varric is the one who ordered Kate's termination.
Yes.
Not Kijima, my uncle. That's a huge spoiler.
Which is the ultimate betrayal. Yes.
You ordered her termination. If she's leaving, I will terminate her. Your words. Exactly.
Well, he's someone very easy to connect with and create a rapport with because he's just such a funny, kind of easygoing spirit to be around. And so that kind of happened naturally. We had those scenes to start with, the scenes where we're working together. And it was his last scene that we shot was the scene at the end of the movie. And she really sort of lets out everything that she really feels about him at this point.
I promise you, it is not what you think it is.
It turns out nothing ever was.
I had been able to play Kate for a while before that as well, so I had been really kind of living with her emotional state. So getting to that point and realizing all this stuff that's been building to this is because of you, you know, and not only for what's happened in Kate and her life, but everything that happened with Ani. Yes, I did this, but also you did this.
Ani, I'm sorry.
When she finds out that Kate killed her father, it's like the ultimate betrayal.
Honey.
You killed my whole family. You bitch!
No, please.
It's so sad for Ani, not only because she finds out that Kate killed her father, but because it also like reminisces past emotions with her family. She's felt past betrayal, and she became really attached to you.
For Kate, in the beginning, she's kind of not wanting to like Ani whatsoever because she does have this reality that she's aware of, that she's done something very terrible to Ani, and trying to think of her as this kid who's a means to an end. She's gonna help me get where I wanna get. And over the course of the film, that breaks down and she has to kind of see that and she has to face what she's done. She has to kind of atone for that in some way.
It's also very heartbreaking to watch when I was watching like the movie for the first time. It's like, oh, this girl doesn't know what happened.
Yeah.
Her father and the truth and everything.
And you know,
and she's
it's
becoming
come.
So yeah. Attached.
Right. But she truly has nothing to lose. I mean, yeah, in all action scenes and all action movies, you could kind of say that, but in this case, it just felt so true. She really had this goal of what she wanted to achieve and just did not care if she died because she was dying anyway. It was really fun to get to go that far with it and be that raw because she only has one goal and then that's it, then life is over. So I think that propels you forward in a huge, huge way. One of the great things about, you know, the action scenes, even though I'm progressively getting sicker and closer to death, is those shots of those drugs that I get keeping to shoot into my leg just for like one last bit of energy. Where she is at that point, just mm-hmm. absolutely giving no fucks whatsoever.
That was one of my favorite shots of the movie, when you walk into the building with the cigarette and the glasses and people are like blazing guns behind you. Because I wasn't there when you filmed that.
Yeah, yeah.
So I was like seeing it for the first time and I was like, oh my God.
Cedric always joked about he was annoyed that we didn't have very many outtakes, but there was one, like the first take that we did of that, I didn't really know all the guns were gonna go off behind me, like for real. And I had the cigarette and the sunglasses and I went like that. And I just tried to play it off and I just like kept walking. I was like, yeah, I knew that was gonna happen. I was like,
it was cool. You even had like a bloody eye contact, which was really cool. How long were you in the makeup chair?
By that point, it was like close to 3 hours in the makeup chair.
Yeah,
it was pretty intense.
It was pretty intense, yeah.
But I loved it. I felt like I looked better the more of that stuff I had.
Bravo, Kate. never doubted you.
After the betrayal, she's absolutely heartbroken, and then she's kind of abandoned again, and then Varric takes her under her wing, and Ani realizes that Varric is not a good person either.
Your girl had to die. That was always the deal, Varric-san.
Kate comes to rescue her, and I feel like she recognizes that. Mm-hmm. Since Ani got to know you, she knows that it's real, and she feels sympathy for you. Because you never got to have that normal life, and at the very end, it's almost like a forgiveness. Like, I see past the built, hard exterior that you put on. It's okay that I found peace with it. Because mm-hmm. Kate's life has never been peaceful. It's been very chaotic since she was younger, and I think I wanted to give you one last moment of peace.
As far as I know, that's the only version that I ever read or was ever aware of. I mean, the only change, I think, is that little line that it's okay. We didn't shoot that. That mm-hmm. was added later. It feels like that was something that was added as just a way to kind of show that everything was going to be okay, you know, for the audience, you know, to maybe feel a bit better about the circumstances.
Yeah. I feel like if you watched and watched again, knowing Woody's character was bad, people would be like, don't get in the car, Ani.
Right.
Don't get in the car with him.
My hope is also that you just are enjoying the journey of this film so much that the sort of twists or how it ends doesn't necessarily really matter in terms of your enjoyment of the film, because just being on the ride for wherever it goes is so much fun and such a like adrenaline rush.
So suspenseful.
Yeah.
Check out Kate now streaming on Netflix.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.